Yajou, Dashu, or good afternoon, listeners. You're listening to the Do Good Talk Show on Wisconsin's radio station WNRB-LP 93.3 FM, happening every third Thursday of the month from 12 to 12:30. My name is Yengyee Lor, President and CEO of Faithful Consulting, a business focused on creating social change in the workplace through coaching, consulting, and training. The vision and mission of the Do Good Talk Show is to connect and share knowledge that can help you or those you love. Last year, we asked what you wanted to hear, and we have a full list of topics that we have been discussing. Today, we will be talking about self-awareness and assessments. Please feel free to call in our show with any questions on this topic, 715-841-0137. Again, that's 715-841-0137. So what is self-awareness? Self-awareness is our ability to look inward, really be objective, think deeply about our behaviors and consider how it aligns with our moral standards and values. It is your objective assessment of yourself. It is honest, factual, and truthful. It's not looking it from your own lens, but that lens of maybe someone else or your higher self is sometimes what is referred to. So looking at the lens from your higher self and assessing your behaviors, thoughts, and actions. It is seeing whether your behaviors align with who you are and want to be. It is seeing if others' perspective aligns with your behaviors, who you are, and who you say you are. There is that almost internal and external factor of viewing yourself. The internal is assessing how you view your behavior, your values, who you are, and also taking that external factor into the self-awareness component of how others may perceive you. So maybe if you got a comment from a coworker or family saying, gosh, you really don't look very friendly, for example, you might want to take that into consideration. Here's another example. Our coworker may see us as lazy for coming in late versus our child's teacher sees us as a great parent for taking the time to drop off the kids at school. But self-awareness is really seeing all of those things from an internal, external lens and really being objective and honest. Just taking the information in for ourselves and then aligning it. Is who we say we are actually who we are? So asking yourself some of those deep reflective questions to just make sure that you don't have any blind spot. That's really the opportunity of self-awareness, is seeing if we have blind spots that we might not be aware of, and how we can change, what we can do in order to be more in alignment with our values, with who we say we are, and who we want to be. There are many, many benefits to self-awareness. For me, it has helped me greatly to be a better person, not only to my family, friends, community, but also to myself. Self-awareness has really allowed me to correct behaviors that I am not very proud of, nor do I want to continue behaving. Other benefits in self-awareness is making sure that our relationships are healthy. So the extent of our relationship to another person is really through our self-awareness. Sometimes without the self-awareness, we don't even know how we're behaving towards others and how others are perceiving us. And so that could be detrimental in our ability to connect, create those authentic relationships that are long-lasting. So it's really critical, not only for you as a person to be self-aware, but as leaders in the community to be very aware of your own behaviors, thoughts, and what others may perceive about you. So what are some ways if you wanted to be more self-aware? The greatest way is to ask for feedback. And ask for feedback from people who can be honest with you. So that means maybe a colleague, a supervisor, someone within your organization. But also don't forget to ask feedback from family as well. All feedback, any kind of feedback, is really helpful to just process, think about, and see where there are alignment, meaning, yeah, that is me. That's who I want to be. Great. And celebrating that you are exactly what you say you are. And then also opportunities where you can grow and develop. I think the more that I have been able to just correct my behavior or look within myself, there's also this great sense of peace. So I didn't say that in the benefits section, but like becoming more self-aware as a leader, I have become more at peace with things, just like knowing who I am and having so much compassion for the human in me, and that there are things that I'm good at, things I'm not good at. I make mistakes. Gosh, do I make mistakes? And I also have lots and lots of successes as well. That has really humbled me as a person, really have compassion for who I am. And with that, I am so compassionate towards other people and respectful of other people. So another way to become more self-aware is to make time for reflection. I do this a lot on a daily basis. I usually think about my behaviors at the end of the night. So in the beginning of the day, I set my heart's intention. Like, what do I want this day to feel, be encompass? And then at night, I reflect on, did I act in alignment with what I set for myself for the day? Was there opportunities for me to grow? So this doesn't have to take very long. It could literally take like 5 to 10 minutes of just reflecting on your day and what that looks like for yourself. But always, always schedule time for reflection. It's like that gentle pause and reminder to say, gosh, I need to stop this autopilot that I'm on. And I really, really need to be intentional about living, intentional about who I am. So it's a gift to yourself, self-reflection. The other is have critical conversations. Really, when someone says something to you and you might not agree with, just think about it. Just pause and think about it. I have been told, because I have a strong personality in terms of, like, I'm not afraid to speak my mind and my thoughts. Doesn't mean I always have to be right, but how other perceives is that, oh, she wants to always be right, or she's dominating the conversation, or she's doing this and that. And this was like many, many years ago, 7, 8 years ago, when I was privy to feedback from my family. And I really appreciate it because it allowed me to step back and say, huh, is that really me? Like, do people, do my family, people I care and love, think that way about me? Like, I am dominating situations and, you know, just have a strong way of leading, which is totally opposite. So my home life is totally opposite from my work life, where I'm able to take charge, but yet I'm very team oriented. And how do we get along at work? So it was just reflecting on the two different worlds that, and two different extremes of my behavior that I was able to, and also having those critical conversations with the people, getting that feedback and having those critical conversations with people that I'm like, huh, wow, at work, I guess maybe I am perceived not to be take charge and not leadership. So how do I correct that? Because I know I'm very capable of leading and very capable of making decisions and moving forward. And at home, I am able to say, okay, I really don't want to be a person who dominates a conversation, situations. I don't want to have to take charge. In fact, if someone could, that'd be great. So I had to really step back and say, okay, when do I just not even need to play a leader role in this? And who else will step up? Crazy enough, everybody kind of fills in where roles need to be played. So totally cool. Another way to become more self-aware is to really go back to assessing like our situations day to day and seeing like, okay, the decisions I'm making, the actions I'm taking, is that in alignment again with my values? So just really, really dissect all the actions and behaviors and thoughts. So your decision making. So if you made a decision to maybe change your career, like dissecting that and making sure, like, am I really taking the right career direction that is in alignment with what my intentions is, what I want, how I want to improve, etc. So those are some other ways. And you might have your own way, you know, so this is not an inclusive list of becoming self-aware. Sometimes it's going through a really, really tough time in your life. And that's when it hits you like, whoa, I really need to pause here and take time to reflect on who I am. Sometimes it's life that forces us to be self-aware. But the proactive approach is just to practice that self-awareness each and every day, because then you're living that intentional life that you want to live. So those are different ways of self-awareness. And for my Hmong family, friends, colleagues, connection out there, self-awareness is really your self-awareness, je mika hai tia your halu self-awareness da shi kha am lu mau na ke bao you to king. Self-awareness is bao you to king, tao you bao you to king na je you tell you bao de o ku your kha ku to king mi ja ku pu nie ku to king ku wali no ku ku to ki pu join no ku pu nie ku to pu ki pu join no ma ku yo long ja. So so okay, about you to king the battle, though, yeah, battle you to king a lush la car, tear la girl, tear la long you to dupe, got dolly you Lucian near, tear high there, you saw it to dreaming Jean Lita. All right, so I'm gonna move forward to what are assessments, because that's part of our conversation today, and that's the rest of our 15 minutes that we're gonna spend together. Again, if you have questions, please don't hesitate to go on our website, message us through all of our avenues of contact, whether it's email, through our social media, and I'll share more at the end. But don't hesitate to contact us if you're more curious about how do I become self-aware. This next phase of assessments correlates with our main topic of self-awareness. So self-awareness, another tool, great tool, is assessments. That's one objective, instrumental way that you can become more self-aware without other people necessarily telling you, or if you don't want to ask for feedback, as I mentioned, or you want other forms of feedback. This is one form. Assessments are one form, a tool that can help you better understand your behavior tendencies, the traits that show up for you as a leader, as a person. So there are many, many types of assessments. There's intelligence assessments, there's personality assessments, there are emotional intelligence assessments. So lots and lots of tools for us to just become more and more self-aware and see where there are opportunities for us to change and celebrate, truly, truly celebrate when we're in alignment with who we want to be. So let me see here. So that's a little bit about self-assessments as a tool that we can utilize to be more self-aware as a leader, as a person. We had asked, as when we posted this agenda for our radio show today up and our social media platform on Facebook, we had a couple questions. So I'm going to answer those questions for our listeners out there. So one question is, how can organizations ensure assessments are equitably conducted and rated? So I think before we even ask this question, I think we have to first decide, like, like what is that intention for this assessment? So it's important to understand the tool and what the tool does. So the assessment tool and what it does. Understand the research behind this assessment. So I feel like we almost have to take a few steps back and really evaluate the assessments that we're going to utilize. Because I think that gets at the question of equitability and making sure that this is a tool that is relevant for people of color, the diverse workforce within an organization. And then there's research, reliability, and validity behind this assessment for the purpose and intention that you're utilizing this tool for. So really, you don't want to use a tool that says, hey, we're not a selection tool for selection criteria. You just don't want to do that. You just don't want to use the wrong tool for the intention. So get your intentions right first. That's what I would say. And then when you actually conduct and rate it to the second part of the question of this individual, how do you ensure assessments are equitably conducted and rated? I think, again, when we know what that intention is and our employees that fit that intention, like, hey, we're assessing every single employee that comes into our workforce, we're using this assessment because we want to learn more about just strengths, weaknesses, skills, etc. Okay, great. So then every employee that does come into the organization should be receiving this tool. So I hope that answers this question. And making sure, like, when whoever is doing or implementing these assessments are certified by the assessment tool itself, that is really important. So just, like, don't purchase like an assessment and not go through a certification process of the tool. Yeah, you don't want that person to be interpreting the results. You want a certified assessor in the tool to interpret those results. That's really important. So hopefully I'm able to answer that question for our listener. Here's the second question. How would you advise organizations to use assessments within their recruitment process? So first off, assessments is one tool, and it should just be one tool. I'm really passionate about assessments, and I love assessments. We at Faithful Consulting utilize assessments for leadership, personal, professional development, as well as for selection. So I'm really passionate about assessments, but it is one tool. So assessments in itself provides one point of data. You need other multiple points of data to really make a thoughtful decision in the recruitment process. Because an assessment without the context is just a tool, a tool without all the information. So it's just kind of like when we're talking about self-awareness today, we don't have that 360 look. We actually have one look, one data point. So I do want to kind of forewarn that, yes, very, very important to use assessments in recruitment process, because I think you will find, here's the benefits of it. It's a very objective tool where you get to see a picture, a data point, and just say, will this person not only fit, but add value to our organization? So I would see that. And also, okay, all right, if we're going to hire this person, what are some things that maybe we can discuss about developmental opportunities? So using it as a tool for development as well. So using it for well-intentioned purposes and not for bad intentions. All right. So that's my two cents on just assessments and recruitment process. But the benefits, I think I've already mentioned some of the benefits. So I will say that these tools are phenomenal in team buildings and just helping that leader like get acclimated. Like if I did an assessment on an individual and I'm doing assessments for an organization right now, we are their contracted assessment organization or provider, I should say, provider. And they use it as a way to really bring the team together, work together, better together, get to know each other, and have those tough conversations that isn't about a person, but is about like behaviors that might come into conflict as the team work together, and how do you work around those things. So I see assessments as being utilized in a very positive intent that way. And so I think the organization assessments is an investment. So the organization has to see if there is value in that. And I will tell you, there's so much value in assessments. There really is. I've not done an assessment for an organization in all my 8 years of business, and that individual did not get personal benefit, as well as the organization did not get personal benefit from the information shared, because it's a data point, a discussion point. It's not a end-all be-all kind of tool. It's a strictly, how do we have some conversations around what we're seeing that shows up in assessment? So there's so many different ways to use assessments, and it's so cool, and I'm really geeked out about assessments. So I hope those answers the two questions around assessments for our viewers. And I'm happy to talk more about self-awareness and assessment as a whole with anybody that would love to learn more. I'm really passionate about these two topics because it's something that has really helped me in my life to really correct myself as a person. To end our discussion, can you believe it's already almost half an hour? We only have a few minutes left. I just want to end up with a few things that is happening at Faithful Consulting. So sign up for our Vision Board Accountability Group. This is a drop-in. So you can drop in every month of the year. So you can do every month. Or you can just drop in when you have the time. We understand that life happens. That's the thing with accountability, is that life happens. So how can you plan in as much as those, you know, plan in proactive actions so that you can not experience so much of the turmoil from life, right? The different things that life brings you. So it takes planning. It takes thinking through what are some of those things that might come my way. So the Vision Board Accountability Group does that. It is a group where individuals can come and really get some feedback from the whole group. We go through and coach folks on where they at with their goals, what are some of the challenges, what can we do to get unstuck. We help each other with brainstorming ideas, resources, etc. It's really, really a great group. So I would love for you to sign up for our Vision Board Accountability Group, and you can do that through our website, faithfulconsulting.com. You can also follow us on LinkedIn, Instagram, Facebook, and Twitter. We have all social media handles and love to connect with you. Whatever preference that you might want to connect with us through social media, we are there and we want to be of value and resource for you. Last but not least, tune in next month to learn about culture and leadership as a BIPOC. BIPOC stands for Black Indigenous Person of Color or People of Color. And I will specifically talk from the lens of an Asian American leadership component. So tune in to next month. I look forward. Please send your questions in if you have any. And remember to spread goodness. Talk Asian Doshada. Signing off, this is Yengyee Lor, President and CEO of Faithful Consulting.